The nets are hung like stockings with care, with hopes that many points will soon be theirs. Certainly, East Wake varsity basketball brings its presence to Rollsville High before the Christmas fast break. Now, those Warriors and these Rams seek to stuff their records by jingling some rivalry victory bells. Winter weather outside, hot contest inside. Looks like a hoopy holiday to me, just for you. There certainly would be no blue Christmas around the red and white seasonally colored gym, because visiting East Wake in its dark colors received two lumps of cold, ice cold. While both Ram rosters were roasting their best shots over an open fire, striking 43 of 86 total attempts for 50% accurate, the opposing Warrior clubs combined to miss 96 of 117 accumulated aims. That's 82% briquettes. The Rollsville girls, in fact, led a majority of their 54-39 upset victory based on its own go-o, trumping the Warriors N-O. The victorious Rams shot 45% from the floor, while East Wake ended 14 of 66, or just 21% makes. Rollsville raises the overall mark to 7-6, but a more important 2-2 in the Greater News River Conference. After ejecting East Wake at 9-3 overall, now 5-1 in the league, from a previous three-way first-place tie triangle among the division. The Lady Rams spread some 15-6 better on its topping toast, just 8 minutes deep, despite a mutually slow-mo scoring spree following the tip-off. It took East Wake nearly 5 minutes to hit its first basket. Rollsville then netted four of its last five down the opening quarter stretch. Number 13, Jalen Powell, posted 6 of her 14 total points and pulled 9 of her 14 total rebounds during that spree. East Wake's Tamira Knuckles knocked 6 of her team-best 16 points during the second stanza when the Warriors wore out the free throw strike. They relentlessly invaded the lane, drawing 10 Ram fouls and eventually attempting 13 charity chops. But they sank just 5, which explains why they were only able to reduce the deficit by just 1. It was 25-18 at the half. In the third, Rollsville set the tone with a quick 7-0 run, wrangling a double-digit advantage. That's where it would stay, as Ram number 22, Valencia Carroll, corralled 10 points, 4 board grabs, and an assist amid the 16-6 team stretch to a 41-24 lead at the conclusion of the third. Carroll finished with 20 points, 17 of those in the second half alone, plus 9 rebounds in her starring role. East Wake struggled for just 3 of 16 field goals and 0 of 7 three-point futility during that downslide. The Warrior bright spot proved to be persistent post player number 24, Tamia Williams. Her 6 points were reinforced by a dominant window cleaning exhibition. In fact, she wiped the glass for 18 total rebounds, including a whopping 12 on the offensive end alone. She personally spurred 14 second chance points for the squad. Even Williams' wild grabs gobbling could not dent the rampage much. Roseville wrapped 5 of 11 shots in the frame and 3 or 4 free throws to prevent any late enemy rally. East Wake simply could find no cure for its lack of accuracy. So Roseville gunned and stunned the favorite festively. But as bad as the East Wake's girls' marksmanship proved, the Warrior guys were crippled by an even worse curse in its 56-32 routing by Roseville. The Ram guys improved to 3-1 in the league, sneaking to within one of co-leaders Garner and Clayton. They are now 5-7 overall. Roseville used frequently hot hands alongside East Wake's bout of absolute drought to maintain out-front momentum most of the contest. The host 4 first quarter three-pointers jacked a quick 20-8 edge. Number 11 Ricky Clemens clipped a pair from the perimeter to pad his stellar stats. 18 total points, 6 rebounds, and 3 assists. East Wake stayed afloat, capitalizing on unguarded opportunities. Its 11 of 15 free throw bingos, or 75%, were the only flicks which clicked this whole fright before Christmas. The Warriors benefited from 8 Roseville turnovers in the second quarter. While those error-prone Rams only attempted 6 field goals the entire 8 minutes, East Wake nailed 2 of 3 trays and 3 of 4 charity cha-chings to whittle the gap to 25-23 at the half. Warrior number 0 Davion Vick became that spurt's hero. He held all 8 of his points during that stretch, from beyond the arc, from mid-range, and from the line. Though East Wake hung improbably close, considering its troubleshooting from the floor, a 14-minute brick-laying blackout slammed the comeback door anymore. The Warriors, in fact, missed 23 straight sticks from every angle and every distance in the building over a field goal failure spanning the entire third quarter till the 1 minute 58-second mark of the fourth. They were a miserable 0 for 13 in the third session alone following intermission. Meanwhile, Roseville scored 7 of 9 launches. Clemens exploded with 10 tacks during an 18-3 departing party. Number 30, Jamal Farrar, added all 6 of his points, representing a total package filled with 7 rebounds and 4 blocks. That front court, back court dynamite duo dismantled East Wake's dwindling hopes. The Warriors continued their frozen tenure, trapped beneath that Arctic Circle, by icicling the opening 8 shots in the fourth. By the time Evan King connected from 20 feet away on the wing, Roseville had already engineered another 11-0 romp, which took a 17-point third quarter gap to 28, thanks to 5 of 9 field goals swished. For East Wake, the least wax condemned it to a sleigh ride. It clanked 9 of 51 from the floor, just 18%. And shanked 4 of 17 beyond the tray zone, just 23.5%. Accelerating Roseville's romp was the fact that it protected the rock. It committed just 5 possession blunders over a 24-minute 51-17 scoring blitz. At the same time, East Wake endured a blizzard. The East Wake boys bowed out at 4-7 overall, 1-3 in the Greater News River Conference. We'll be right back.